Amiodarone is effective for the treatment of wide varieties of atrial and ventricular tachyarrhythmias in children. Amiodarone can prolong an AV conduction and ultimately slow the heart rate by elongating the AV refractory period, the QRS, and the Q to T intervals. Now, because amiodarone is an alpha and beta blocker and also blocks sodium, potassium, and calcium channels, it's a well-known drug as a multi-channel blocker. Some of the indications for the drug amiodarone as an antiarrhythmic drug is that it's going to be used specifically for its broad range of electrophysiologic effects. Amiodarone is primarily chosen for PALS as a first-line antiarrhythmic agent for cardiac arrest because it has reliably and clinically shown effectiveness in increased survival to hospital admission, but not in hospital discharge compared to other medications, interestingly enough. Amiodarone may be considered for treatment of pulseless VTAC, VFib, and hemodynamically stable SVT refractory to vagal maneuvers and adenosine. So now let's take a look at some precautions and contraindications. You see, with amiodarone, there are multiple complex drug interactions, so care must be given when using this drug. Rapid infusion may lead to hypotension. Of course, during cardiac arrest, there is no blood pressure, and therefore the American Heart Association recommendation is still rapid IV push for treatment of pulseless conditions. Do not administer amiodarone with other drugs that prolong the QT interval, such as procainamide. Because terminal elimination and the half-life is very long, amiodarone can be a complicated medication to work around when treating a patient who's experienced return of spontaneous circulation. Amiodarone administration may eliminate the option to use certain medications until it has been effectively eliminated from the body. A pediatric cardiologist or similarly experienced provider should direct long-term amiodarone therapy. Looking at the pediatric dosage now, when using amiodarone to treat VFib or pulseless VTAC, the first dose is going to be 5 milligrams per kilogram IV or IO push. This may be repeated one or two times for refractory VFib or pulseless VTAC. For life-threatening arrhythmias, the maximum cumulative dose is going to be 2.2 grams IV or IO over a 24-hour period. For supraventricular and ventricular arrhythmias with poor perfusion, a loading dose of 5 milligrams per kilogram infused over 20 to 60 minutes may be given. Repeat doses of 5 milligrams per kilogram may actually be given up to a maximum of 15 milligrams per kilogram per day as needed.